the remaining ones, not all remaining ones, but most prominent ones, most important ones, yeah. And then I will mention few other aspects of Bhaktivinoda Stotra. Right. I can sectionalize or divide the whole Bhaktivinoda Stotra in four parts. The first part is about the poem, what poet says about the poem, his politeness, he's saying he's humble, his inability to compose the poem, his inability to describe the virtues of Lord Adinath. That is the first part of Bhaktivinoda Stotra. Then lots of other comparisons, comparison with sun and the moon and the deepak and lots of other things. Very beautiful verses. Then the third part, I described last week, felicitations, pratiharyas, eight divine happenings, you know, and it was like a meditation. We imagine that we are in the assembly where Lord Mahavir or Lord Adinath or any other Tirthankar is preaching. And the fourth part is completely different kind of section, fourth part. Many of our stotras and prayers and other things, you know, we mention that the stotra or this poem or this prayer is capable of removing our difficulties, our disease, our fears. So the fourth part here is exactly like that. Fears. And the Bhaktivinoda Stotra is capable of removing all our fears, our worries, our obstacles, everything. And there have been prayers, not only in Jain literature, in Hindu literature as well. You know, even if you see Hanuman Chalisa, Hanuman Chalisa is like that. That is why perhaps it's more popular. People say that, oh, Hanuman Ji will do this, will do that, remove my fears and everything. You know, Parshnath Bhagavan Stotras are like that. Even Uvasagaram Stotra. The stotra itself, the name suggests Uvasagaram, the stotra which can remove your obstacles. In nine recitations, Navsmaran, the fifth one is for Bhayabhara Stotra. That means the stotra which can remove all the fears. Of course, it is more known as Namiyon Stotra, but it's also called Bhayabhara Stotra. So, Bhaya, fears. What fears we have? First of all, imagine in olden times, and there was no electricity. Sometimes very difficult to even imagine, isn't it? There was no electricity 150, 200 years ago. Even when I was born in my village, there was no electricity. And when there was night, total darkness everywhere. You know, you couldn't see from there to there. And lots of other things. There are no means of communications. Now we have got everything. Mobile phones, emails, WhatsApp, you know, whatever. Everything we have got. Yeah. There was not even a postal system. Not only emails and mobile phones, everything. No postal system. You know, that came in just 150 years ago. It's surprising there was no. And lots of other things, no new inventions. So, how was the life like? People, sometimes they were living in fears in small villages. They'll think about it. The elephant might come, a lion might come, a snake might come, you know. There are snakes everywhere in small villages, in the fields and everywhere. I myself have seen lots of snakes in India. And what about the other fears? Fear of disease, ailments, there are no proper cures. TB, plague, even diarrhea and cholera were deadly diseases. And what else? Fear of battles, wars, and fear of imprisonment. Because the rulers, sometimes some kings were so cruel, they will take you away, imprison you, and do all sorts of things. That was a real fear too. So people were living in fears, and all sorts of fears have been mentioned in our scriptures, in our literature. In the Bhairava Stotra, in this Namyam Stotra, they also mentioned fear of robbers and thieves. That's also a real fear, isn't it? Fear of journeys. Journey in the sense that people used to travel long distances. They used to travel, they used to go by sea. And once someone goes, you wouldn't know where he has gone, whether he has reached at certain point, certain place or not. Whether he is alive or dead, no communication, no posting, post, nothing. So people were living in fears. And so the poet here describes us and tells us about this fear and says that Lord Adinath's Nam Smarana, prayer, can remove all fears. So this is the fifth part, and let us see this. Here there are eight verses of fears. Elephants, lions, fire, snakes, war, water, sea, ocean, discipline, and imprisonment. Eight types of fears have been mentioned in this stotra. The first is, these verses are quite difficult, of course, here. The language is not that easy. So, who's going to sing, or can we sing together? Yeah. Rajiv.
Stutan Madavila Vilola Kapola Mula Mata Pramada Pramaranada Vivrita Kopam Airavata Bamiba Mudatama Patantam Trishtva Bhayam Bhavatino Bhavadashitanam.
So the first fear of elephants. Nowadays there is no fear of elephants. We have got different types of fears, you know. But in olden times, that was the fear, one of the fear. And what does it say? O Jineshwara, the devotees who have submitted to you are not scared even of a mad mammoth elephant with a dripping must. Elephant is a temple, must bar aave, especially young elephant. That again shows is a sign of its anger. Elephant angry one, the other one is that. Eva angry elephant, and he has become more angry because of all the bees, humming bees, and a trouble for a shetla mate. Evo elephant, the marisamina away. The mad elephant with dripping humor and humming bees around advances towards the meditating devotee. As it approaches near, it calms down and like a pet sits near the devotee. Atle, this is the first thing, that whoever worships Lord Adinatha has got nothing to fear from such elephants. Yeah. This is second fear from lions. Again, there are lions everywhere, especially in some parts of Gujarat. There are lions, you know, there are not many lions, many elephants, and not many snakes. ಗಲದುಜ್ವಲ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ತಾಪ್ತ ಮುಕ್ತ ಫಲ ಪ್ರಕರ ಘೋಷಿತ ಭೂಮಿ ಭಾಗ ಬದ್ಧ ಕ್ರಮ ಕ್ರಮಗತ ಪರಿಣಾದಿ ಕೋಪಿ ನ ಕ್ರಮಿತಿ ಕ್ರಮಯುಗ ಅಚಲ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಟಿಪಿಕಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್, ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೂ ಲೈನ್ಸ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ, ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಸೀ. ಬದ್ಧ ಕ್ರಮ ಕ್ರಮಗತಂ ಹರಿಣಾದಿ ಕೋಪಿ ನಾಕ್ರಾಮತಿ ಕ್ರಮಯುಗ ಚಲ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಂ ತೇ. ದ ಯೂಸೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ರಮ, ವಿಚ್ ಹಸ್ ಗೋಟ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದಿ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪೋಯೆಟ್. ಹೌ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಒನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓ ಜಿನೇಶ್ವರ, ferocious lion tears open the temples of elephant and scatters around white bone pearls made crimson with blood. Even such angry and roaring lion, ready to leap at its prey, gets pacified and does not attack a devotee who has taken shelter at your secure feet. So your devotee is free of the fear of ferocious lion. That's what the description says. Even a lion cannot come to such a person. The word baddha kramaha, the lion is about to jump. Kramagatam, slowly coming towards you. See, the same word, krama, krama. Nakramati, he cannot attack you. Same word, krama. Krama yuga chala sanskritam te. Those who take shelter under your two feet. Krama yuga chala. See the beauty of poem. One word, use krama, 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 four times with different meanings. Another fear is fear of fire. You might wonder why there is fear of fire, but people are afraid of fire because in the dry weather, in hot weather, you can see there are fires in Australia or sometimes in California. You know, there is fire, and fire starts burning. It can destroy so many houses in just few hours. So kalpant kal pavanottata varnikalpam davanalam jvalitam ujjvalam spulingam visvam jagat sumiva sammukam apatantam tvannama kirtana jala samayati asesham. Tivo fire in world, it's a nice description. Ojina, even the all consuming forest conflagration, as if kindled by the doomsday tempest and having sparkling flames, is extinguished in no time by the quenching stream of your name. Smaran Navrishan, that is your devotee has no fear of fire. Evo fire var kethaik jane akshi dunya ne gari jese evo fire kon kain concept on thi karan ke why tvat nama kirtana jala, the water. ಕೈ ವಾಟರ್ ನಾಮ ಕೀರ್ತನ ತಾರ ಸ್ಮರಣ ರೂಪಾಣಿ ತಾರ ಕೀರ್ತನ ರೂಪಾಣಿ ಏನಾ ಉಪರ ಪಡೆ ಫಾಯರ್ ಕೋನ್ ಕೈ ಕರಿ ಸಕ್ಸೆ ನೀ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸ್ನೇಕ್ಸ್. ಸ್ನೇಕ್ಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಯು ನೋ ದೇ why people knew India as a country of snake charmers. You know, some of the stories and some even English film, you see that an Englishman comes to India and first thing he sees is what? Snake charmer and someone doing the rope trick, you know, these things, because there were so many snakes everywhere here. Yeah. And I have seen quite a few. I once seen a snake in my house. It wasn't a very big, one of that big, yeah. I was about 14, 15 years old. And that snake was on the first floor, not on the ground floor, first floor in my house. So my elder brother hurriedly went away outside to call someone, to call a neighbor who was very good in catching snakes here. And in the meantime, I was wondering what to do, so I got hold of a fork, chipio, from the kitchen and caught the snake. And I was holding the snake, and my brother came, and that snake catcher person came. Mind you, they were not happy with me. They thought I was quite foolish. Maybe I was, yeah. Just because I was only 14, 15 years old, yeah. So I took the snake in that fork, slowly walked away outside the village, released the snake there, and they said, don't do this again. Let the experts do this thing, not you. Sorry. But that's what happened. But as I said, it wasn't a very big snake, but snake is a snake. You never know, it might have been poisonous snake, yeah. So, rakte kshanam samadha bhogila kantha nidham krodhutaram khani utpanam apatantam akramati kramayuga nirashta santam pannam nagadaman radiyasya punsa. Kyo snake chan description, I question picture, let us see this picture here. Yeah.
See at the bottom of the picture,
it has got a blue around the thing there, yeah? That shows that it's a very poisonous snake. Even such a poisonous snake, a devotee who has absorbed the antitoxin of her pious name crosses fearlessly over an extremely venomous and hissing serpent that has blood red eyes, peach black body, obnoxious appearance and raised hood. There is one beautiful word used here. Tvan nama nagadamani hridayasya punsaha. That man has got nothing to fear of from that snake, because he has got nagadamani, means a special knowledge, a special medicine which can cure the poison of any poisonous snake. So nama nagadamani, and that nagadamani, that medicine is your name, is your smarana. Before I mention the legs, one more thing I would like to mention. When I was a little child, that time about 8 or 10 years old, wasn't a lion or an elephant, mind you, just was an ox, a bull. We are living in a little village. The street was very narrow where we used to live. And next to our house, there were lots of some farmers. They had a lot of cows and oxes, bulls, you know, yeah. So one evening, all the cows and bulls and came running fiercely towards our house. And I was playing outside my house, didn't know what to do, there was nowhere to go or run. came towards me. I was about 8 or 10 years old. I just stood there in the middle, hoping that nothing would happen. This bull came near me, very near, just stopped. And I'm sure it looked at me, looked at this little child, and just went away. So I still remember that event, that how could that happen, you know? I wasn't reciting Bhaktamar Stotra. But sometimes something or God saves you. And I have narrated this particular incident in one of my novels, Gujarati novel I have written here, in a different way, how that bull came, saw in person's eyes, you know, that look in person's eyes, and then calmly just turned away and walked away, you know. The fifth fear of the army or battles, that was also a real fear. People, the rulers and the small kings used to fight all the time, you know. Land, property, sometimes even for beautiful women, fighting going on all the time between kingdoms. And it doesn't even just happen in India, it has happened everywhere in the whole world, you know. Yeah. Samson and Delilah, Solomon and Sheba, Helen of Troy, you know the stories of fighting everywhere, yeah. So, the fifth fear of army and battles. Bhargat Turang Gajagarjita Bhiman Adar Majobalam Balvatam Api Bhupati Nam Uddit Divakara Mayukh Sikha Pavitham Tvat Kirtana Katam Ivasu Vidam Peti. What does it say? The army of mighty kings, where the horses are running at full gallop and where the elephants are making fierce noises by roaring, is immediately retreated on the battlefield by praising you. It is like the darkness which is destroyed when pierced by the sharp ends of the rays of the rising sun. Your devotee is free of the fear of such enemies. Another fear of battles, more or less same as the other one. I'll just see the translation. The fifth fear of war: in the battlefield, streams of blood are flowing from the bodies of elephants, pierced by spears. In such a fierce battle, the devotee bows down at the lotus feet of the Jina and advances. He defeats the enemy and returns victorious. The sixth fear is the fear of water. Manas traveling ma jaye, seafarers, pachi kya gayo, kyare pacha hose, gayo ka nathi kahin, khabar nathi. And our Indian people used to travel everywhere, you know that. Apne record nathi rakhya koi years. People used to go to Indonesia, all the time. That is why all the names are Indian names. Sumatra, Java, and people's name in Indonesia are Indian names. Sukarno, all those names here. Yeah. They are all Hindus. Now only one island is Hindu island, which is that is a small island, Bali. When Java and Sumatra and Borneo and Buddha, Muslim take care. Thailand. Our people used to go to Thailand all the time. That strong Hindu culture was there. Even the name of the town, the famous town Ayodhya. You might have seen Ayodhya. They call it Ayodhya. It's Ayodhya where Bhagwan Ram was born. It is Ayodhya in India where Ram was born. But Ayodhya in Thailand as well. And they kept the same name there. And when you visit Thailand, you You will see the story of Rama everywhere. And same thing in Indonesia. They still do the plays of Ramayana all the time in Indonesia. What about Cambodia? The largest Hindu temple is there, isn't it? So our people used to travel. Even in Lord Mahavir's time, people used to go to Aden. And Aden was called Ardrak. Ardrak. And there is a story of Ardrak Kumar, who came from Aden to learn some few things from Mahavir Swami. So people used to travel. And when they were traveling, of course, apne kaam na padega, pahuncha, nahi pahuncha, letter na aage, phone na aage, jab to kasu hai nahi. Mari gaya chhe ke jeeve chhe, ye pan khabar kumare. Atle, that was a very big fear. Mbhoni to kshubita vishana nakra chakra पाठीन पीठ भयदोल वाह अग्नि रंगत तरंग शिखर स्थितियां पात्राम त्रासन विहाय स्मरणा भजंती. ओ इक्वानिमस ए ब्रॉड सी कॉट एट द क्रेस्ट ऑफ जायंट वेव्स एंड सराउंडेड बाय अटैकिंग एलिगेटर्स जायंट ओशनिक क्रीचर्स एंड मरीन फायर. With the help of your name chanting, the devotee surmounts such horrors and cross the ocean. Another fear is the fear of disease. ये तो अत्याय बताने वाले हैं. अपन ने कहीं थे जाए तो मन मासूम था कि मैंने आम थे क्यों से टेम थे क्यों से बराबर नेचुरल थे कि કારણ કે બધાને ડિઝીઝની બીક લાગે કે આમ હશે આમ હશે. કંઈ દુખતું હોય તો ડૉક્ટર પાસે જઈએ કે સ્કાન કરાવી આ કરાવી તે કરાવી. કારણ ફ્યુર ઓફ ડેથ ઇઝ ઓલવેઝ ડેડ. ફ્યુર ઓફ ડિઝીઝ ઇઝ ઓલવેઝ ડેડ. તો એમાં બહુ સુંદર ડિસ્ક્રિપ્શન છે. ધ મોર્ટલ્સ બેન્ડ ડાઉન અંડર ધ બર્ડન ઓફ ધ ડ્રેડફુલ ડિઝીઝ ઓફ ડ્રોપ્સી. ડ્રોપ્સી એ જલંધરનો રોગ કહેવાય છે, જેમાં પેટ મોટું થઈ જાય. એ એવું થઈ ગયું હોય વર રિડ્યુસ ટુ અ ડિપ્લોરેબલ કન્ડિશન એન્ડ વી હેવ લોસ્ટ ઓલ હોપ ઓફ સર્વાઈવિંગ. એવો માણસ હોય તો પણ વોટ હેપન્સ, ફૂલી રિકવર્સ એન્ડ બીકમ્સ મોસ્ટ હેન્ડસમ વેન દે એનોઇન્ટ ધેર બોડીઝ વિથ ધ નેક્ટર લાઈક પાર્ટિકલ્સ ટેકન from your lotus feet. Most handsome thai. Ena mate word likho chhe makar dhvaj tulya rupa. Makar dhvaj. Makar dhvaj etle kon? Kamdev. In the Hindu mythology, it's considered most handsome deva or person, makar dhvaj. Ane kamdev kevay chhe. English ટ્રાન્સલેશન નથી, પણ સમટાઈમ્સ વી યુઝ ધ વર્ડ ક્યુપીડ, સી યુ પી આઈ ડી, બરાબર છે. પણ મકર ધ્વજ એને કામદેવ કહે છે, એને કે બહુ મોસ્ટ હેન્ડસમ પર્સન. તો જે માણસને રોગ થયો હોય, અચ્યુત જીવિત આશા, એટલે એમ થશે કે આ તો જાણે હવે મરી જશે, એવો માણસ પણ શું થાય છે, મકર ધ્વજ તુલ્ય રૂપા, હી ઇઝ કમ્પ્લીટલી ક્યોર. Eighth fear is the fear of imprisonment. I imprisoned the batayushi. So you can see if the person has been imprisoned, put in jail, he is in chains. In a prison, a person is lying heavily chained. He chants the name of the jina and chains and shackles break down automatically and returns home. પછી આમાં બધા અપેક્ષા શેખા છે, નામ મત્ત, વિપેન્દ્ર, મિસ એલિફન્ટ, ભૃગરાજ મિસ લાયન, દવાનળ મિસ ફાયર, અન્ની સ્નેક, Sangram, battle. Varidhin is ocean. Mahodar is the disease. And Bandhan is imprisonment. All these fears can be destroyed when one chants your name. The last one, here it says, a beautiful comparison, very nice comparison. Stotra Sarajantava Jinendra Gune Nibhutta Paktyamaya Harichurvarna Chitra Pushpam. This particular poem is like a garland. When someone makes garland, he has to use lot of flowers. Flowers of Jajida, very nice, beautiful flowers. But this poem is like a garland, and I have used lot of beautiful words in making this garland. And whoever wears this garland, in other words, whoever remembers this poem, so check kanthagata. Kanth means neck or throat. Je neck upar a garland rakhe, ene bhagwan male chhe. But the real comparison is je throat ma a poem ne remember kare chhe, ene he gets Lord Adinatha. And what else happens? Tam manatungam avasha sampeti lakshmi. Again, one word, two different meanings. Manatunga is the name of the acharya, name of the poet who has composed this stotra. Manatunga means elevated status, whose prestige has increased. So, a manasu bane, the one who remembers thy name, he becomes Manatunga. And Samupeti Lakshmi, to him, Lakshmi comes to him. And Lakshmi kai se, it's not just prosperity, it's the Lakshmi of moksha. Every word has got two different meanings. The poem is like a garland. Flowers are the different words. Manatunga is the name of the poet and also prestigious position. And Lakshmi is prosperity as well as moksha. That is what happens when you remember or recite this Bhaktamar Stotra. We'd like to mention other points in a Bhaktamar Stotra. Miraculous effect is okay. Someone else has done this particular thing. It is on website or no? There is another other aspects of the Bhaktamar Stotra. Something about yantras and mantra. This particular stotra is full of mantra and yantra. Mantra to kone ke bhai mantra tamne badane khabar chhe. Ke suppose you say Om Ring Arhum Namaha, Om Ring Sri Parshnathaya Namaha. These are the mantras. Abhida mantra kya hai chani? Mantra ma always shuru hai. Usually there is a Om, a starting syllable or beach or seed. And that usually Om is the first letter or the first sound when this universe was created. That is what our scriptures say. Om. Universe began with the sound of Om. It's called Pranava Mantra. And in Hindu religion, in Jain religion, and Buddhist religion, Om is the most important word or beat. And then usually we have Rim. Rim is another sea which we use in chanting mantras. Rim is very important. It's made up of Ha, Ra, I, Ma. So if you join Ha, Ha, then Ra and I, Ma, Rim. Because every letter, every sound has got its vibration, the combination of Ha, Ra, I, Ma has got a special kind of vibration. When you speak Rim, a certain vibrations are created, and that is not just useful in chanting mantra, but it helps. Even our scripture says that all sorts of ailments can be cured by chanting Rim, Om Rim. So that is Rim. Then again the other seed is Sri. Sri is always used. Sri is the sound of wealth and beauty. There is another one called Klim. It's the sound of goddess Kali, sound of energy. Incidentally, day before yesterday, I was visiting Asda to pick up my prescription. And the guy who was giving me prescription was a tall West Indian Jamaican fellow. And I was just looking at him, and he had a big tattoo here. And in Sanskrit, it was written clean. I was so tempted to ask him that, how come you have got this sacred mantra seed written in Sanskrit? Big tattoo, you know, permanent. But I did not ask him, maybe next time I will. Clean. So, and that is used in Sanskrit language in a mantra science here. So someone must have given that to him, or someone, he probably knows everything about mantra science. So these are the seeds of mantra. And Jains, Hindus and Buddhist scriptures are full of different kinds of mantras, you know. They used for different things, used at different times to please different gods or goddesses. And Bhaktamastotra is also full of mantra. But not just mantras only, yantras are there. And yantra are diagrams. These diagrams are either carved on copper plate, round copper plate, or square copper plate. Or in Buddhist scriptures or in Buddhist religion, they call them mandalas. It's a different subject altogether. They believe in mandalas, they worship mandalas, we worship yantras, they more or less same, different diagrams. And I'll show you one or two diagrams here. Each verse has got its own diagram. And some people inscribe them on copper plate, keep them in their own houses, and worship them. See, the verse itself is written in the outer boundary. Then there is a thing called Ruddhi. And the mantra itself is at the bottom. And in the middle, different things like Om, Rim, Sri, Sri. If you see this little table, there are 12 squares in one big square, isn't it? Yeah? So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. The sixth is Klim, which I saw on that person's neck. That's Klim. That we are tattooed. So Om, Rim, Sri, Sri. So these are the different type of yantras. And and people admit them in copper, and they anoint them, they wash it with the milk and water and with all sorts of things, and they sit down and they recite this mantra: Om Namo Bhagavate Jayavati Manusamhitaya Moksha Sokham Kuru Kuru Swaha. So each verse has got its own mantra and its own yantra. I'm going to show you just two out of 48. This is another yantra. On top, it says green, sign is green, and at the bottom, it says chrome. In the middle, there is a chain, Om is written. The verse number is written on the thing. So just two yantras I am showing you. Right, there's another thing I can mention it. Chitra Bandham. This is verse number 26. You know, in that particular verse, one word was coming again and again. Tubhyam. So, some of our acharyas have made diagrams. The Tubhyam comes in every verse, in every line of this particular verse. And na, na, na comes. So, this is just an imagination and beautifully written down. Same verse number 26, written down. Tubhyam, Tubhyam, Tubhyam comes, and then each line again. Say, if you go from the middle, Tubhyam, then go up. If you go from the middle, then go down. Go from the middle and go that way. That is, it's called Chitra Bandham. And the German professor I knew in London University, you know, and he was very much interested in all these Chitra Bandham. And he said, I would like to study and read all these things about it. So that's all about Bhaktamala Stotra. And as I said, it's one of our most beautiful, most respected poem written by Manthung Acharya in 7th century. Of course, Jain literature is full of poems, poetry, and other stories. Because our monks had a lot of time. They used to study scriptures, but they had a lot of time. And they were very learned people, our acharyas. And that is why Jain acharyas have written so much, you know, they have composed so many poems, written so many books, that not thousands, but hundreds of thousands of books, Jain books are available. If you want to study any language, you can study language by reading those books or by comparing that, okay, this one was written in 1600, the other one is 1620, then 1640, 1650, 1680, and you will see the difference in language. And that's another thing to study, how the language is developed, how our modern languages came about, you know, from Sanskrit and Prakrit. I probably mentioned once that one gentleman called Mohanlal Galichand Desai has written a book. The book is in Gujarati. It took him 25 years to write that book. It has about 1,050 pages. The book is called Jain Sahitya no Sankshipta Itihas. That means brief history of Jain literature. Brief history of the Jain literature, 1,050 pages. All he has done is mention the names of Jain authors, right from Mahavir Swami to Srimad Ramachandra, and what they have written. you know, the names of the books or names of poems and everything. Yeah. So, I think we are hoping that we have got so much literature, you know. You probably Hindus haven't got that much, you know. Okay, any questions before?